And I'm Christian, and we're A1, and you're watching MTV with A1's videography.
Yes, right.
Or is it videography?
Videography.
Videography.
I like that word.
Okay.
Just 101, that's the way we do it, baby. Just 101, that's the way we do it.
Well, let's start off straight away with our very first video. Now, this is quite some time ago, and I think we can safely say we've changed a little bit. This was back in the day where, you know, we were influenced by a powerful entity that encouraged us to all wear the same trousers. We can all wear the same type of swimming shorts.
Different colours.
It was genius. It was like, I know, let's put A1 all in white trousers, but get this, we're going to put them in different coloured, matching Tommy
and
shirts.
And different training.
I've got to say, it was shot in one of the most beautiful locations in the world, in Puerto Vallarta, in Mexico.
Puerto Vallarta, in Mexico. It was shot by, Phil Griffin?
No, it was actually a guy called Danny Jacobs.
That's right.
Our very first video director.
Of course.
We were new to the whole game, so we didn't know what to expect, so we more or less did did everything. We were directed wisely, and we listened, and I guess we learned.
The great thing about it was that we went on the beach, and we had, like, magic hands. As soon as we did this, we would go one-on-one, and we would magic the people into clothes that they would really never want to wear. There was a couple on the beach that were in kind of really nice, you know, cool beach outfits, and we go and change them to, like, hot, you know, dinnerwear type of stuff. So,
why?
Not quite sure why that was.
I suppose one of the most embarrassing points, it was later that we actually found out that when you do that, it means you're a loser.
Yeah.
So we didn't realise that at the time. We thought we were fantastic.
But
we thought
it was one on one.
We thought it was one on one. Because there's a part of the song that goes just one on one. So that's what we thought that meant. But later everybody was going, God, that means
you're a loser. So we came out with a debut single going, loser, loser, that's the way we do it, baby. Loser, loser. But we did do jet skiing, and I did the most tremendous jump. Didn't mean to, but there was a wave coming in. And Christian was on the back of my jet ski. He was going, man, don't speed up, don't speed up. And it was like the only thing you can do when there's a big wave coming. So we sped up and we did this huge jump, and it looked fantastic on the screen, but we were really turning ourselves.
I think we should watch the video now.
I think we should. Yeah.
We don't throw to videos in this, Chris. Oh, they just play them as we talk.
Oh, fantastic.
Oh, really? That's great.
We're doing it now.
Oh, it's on now.
Clay, I tell you what, let's throw to the bit where we're swimming through the jungle.
No, we're swinging through the jungle right now. I can feel it. We're swinging through the jungle, and we're on the rocks.
And we've all got huge bags under our eyes because we went out until about 6 in the morning the previous night.
I think we've had some great adventures, and this was the first big adventure, and this was the first time we spent ludicrous, silly amounts of money on video. And
not clothes.
That's why I'm wearing string vest
he actually
you
chose
ever
it.
See.
I he chose it. It. He
I
loved that string vest. It was like a brother to him.
He's a brother to Dave.
Did not choose the vest.
The next video we actually shot after Big First Leave was a video called Summertime of Our Lives. It was great, it was another fantastic location, another very expensive location, I must add. We really enjoyed it. This was filmed in the Bahamas.
This was glorious days. It only took us about 3 days, but we stayed out there for another 2 days because there was no point in going all the way to the Bahamas for that short time.
The reason why we shot it here was because we really wanted to swim with dolphins. This is the only place in the world, we understand, that they have trained dolphins in the open sea. We made them do all these tricks, like we were all like aligned in the water and the dolphins would come and jump over us and land straight in front of us. At one point, the dolphin actually missed and the tail landed on my head and knocked me underneath the water. And I swallowed a lot of water and I came up coughing. And it was like, it was as if the dolphin understood that I was in a little bit of a pain. So it swam back to me and started kissing me on the mouth.
It's Christian's first snog for ages. Do you know, we actually had our own island on the video, which was great. Really we had to go from our hotel, which was pretty cool, and we had to get on a boat and go over to our own very own A1 island, which they built a beach hut on there. We actually had a barbecue, didn't we?
But this was great.
But we were like cooking
Mostly flies, really, wasn't it?
Yeah, I'll tell you what they did, though, but they sprayed the whole barbecue with insect repellent, so we couldn't actually eat it, but we had to pretend we were eating it.
This fish that I had caught earlier on, actually, they'd already caught it, and they just put it on the hook, so I come out of the sea with this fish.
You know, I actually got a letter of complaint about it.
I know, because Ben runs in the sea and grabs the fish off me and then pretends that he caught it and does this
and
little...
And I go,
this little cheesy scene where he goes... Right, hey, I caught that fish.
I got a letter of complaint saying, Mark caught that fish, Ben. Why did you say it was your fish? Why did you do that? That's really bad of
you. Just the video. Once again, the white trousers made an appearance.
Oh, yeah. That's
they were different this time. Yeah, you had three-quarter length white trousers, I do believe.
Yeah.
And it's genius, again, with the clothes. I think, looking back, I think A1 have got to be categorised as some of the best-dressed fans in history.
Oh, I'll tell you
why haven't we won any awards for that? I actually enjoyed this video one of the most. I really, it was, as holiday destinations, I think the first two videos were the best.
I think the best thing was that it was shot by Phil Griffin.
Oh yeah, Phil Griffin is a great director. He's done so much stuff.
And then, you know, one of my favourite bits was when we sat down in the evening for a good bit of dolphin steak.
Oh, right. That's so not true.
But apart from the dolphin steak and the flies and the food and the British People's Choice Award for the most gaily dressed band in the world, I had a really good time. Absolutely, it's a dream for all of us, really. Yeah. Hello, you're still watching A1's videography?
Or is it video-o-ography?
Video.
I think if it was hyphenated, it would be videography.
Right.
And if it wasn't, it'd be
videography. Videography.
But we're going to talk about our third video, which is Everytime, which we shot in Morocco. Lately, I'm not who I used to be. Which is in Northern Africa, which we really, really enjoyed. And we didn't actually have like any water in this video, which was a new experience for us. There was no beaches, but there was lots and lots of sand. Exactly what I
had to do. No white trousers.
And no...
But we did have green... We did have green and orange trousers.
No, we
green
orange. Whose idea was that? I don't know. All the things we ever
wanted were once yours and mine. And no, it wasn't just that. We had beige outfits as well.
Beige. That's new.
Woolen beige tops in the beige and sun.
That's what, that's all you need. Every time I kiss, I feel your lips.
And every time I cry, this video was shot, and I'm telling you, in the exact spot that The Mummy Returns was shot. I was just watching it the other day, and the making of it, and The Rock, who's in the film, was saying that it took him, 3 hours to drive from land to the destination. We had to do exactly the same thing. Every morning we'd get up about 4 or 5 o'clock and we'd have to drive into this point of the desert where they had camels waiting for us. Very moody camels, I might add. They were really grumpy.
But belly dancers. Very belly moody dance. Belly dancers, may I add.
We were told that we would be riding the horses and doing stunts on the horses. And we're like, what? Now you're gone. It's time for me to carry on. But on this occasion, we can lift the lid. We didn't do the stunts.
Well, we tried, but then I got flattened by a horse. I think the scariest thing was actually being on the horse's back, and the people that were actually handling the horses, we were saying, what do we do now? Because we'd never ridden a horse. We're going, what do we do now? You know, how do we make it go forward, or how do we make it stop? And they were saying, they were going, I don't know.
We were going,
right, so you're not like professional horse handlers then? They were like, nope, we just came here, you know, we're extras, we're being paid to look like we're handling the horses. So it didn't go very well, to be honest.
It was directed by Phil Griffin again.
It was.
We've done Summertime of Our Lives, and this is my favourite video experience.
Tell you what, one of the problematic things with this video, we tried to stand and make it all beautiful in the desert,
we had to stand in the middle of the desert, but how we get there without getting all the footprints? Yeah. So we had people with like big branches trying to sweep the footprints off. And we had to try to walk around and up this little hill to try to get there. From all the way far back, we could hardly hear the director. We had walkie-talkies, and I walk now, and then we have to walk slowly towards the camera.
That's my favorite bit of the video. It's just, you see us walking over the horizon, very, very blurred, sand blowing up all over the place, our shirts blowing in the wind, and they shot it in slow motion, and when they played it back full play, it was like really, really blowy.
They
didn't use enough of it, but that is my favorite 2 seconds of the video, where you see us walking over the horizon in the desert. I love it. I like the overall look of the desert, but I don't like what we're wearing. I like the beige outfit, but I didn't like my orange shirt. And I have never felt this way since the day I
gave your love away. Skipping forward in time, we're going to be now talking about a video called Take On Me, which was actually our first UK number one. I think it was one of the most expensive videos for Sony UK ever, and it was good because we were in a computer world, and it looks really cool.
We actually shot this on over the space of 3 days. When you have a video as expensive as this, you really can't, you know, shoot for too long because it just costs far too much money. I'm coming for your love, okay. We just had to spend what needed to be spent on this video, so it was very expensive for us. On the first day, what we got out of the way was all the warehouse stuff you see at the beginning and at the end of the video. It was supposed to look like, I guess, secret agents or something, you know, working on saving the world from this deadly virus. It's as though Ben's just sitting on the balcony, just waiting for some action, because he's sitting there with his legs crossed. Then she just, come on, let's go. And he goes, great! And he's got this big cheesy smile on his face.
More like Austin Powers.
Yeah, more like Austin Powers, yeah.
Yeah, baby, yeah! It was filmed in an area called Brixton in London. These three guys came up to visit. Hey, you're that guy, you're that bloke from A1, aren't you? I said, yeah. Oh, can we have your autographs for our nieces and nephews? We love you guys. That's the show, A1. It's fans in all.
I'll tell you what, I think A1's probably the coolest band I've ever seen.
We are pretty cool.
We got the chance to fly.
We got a chance to work with Stuart Dudley for the first time.
Yeah, he was just
excellent. Finished making Show Me the Meaning for the Backstreet Boys.
This was the first video that said a sad farewell to Ben's floppy hair. With 2 hours in makeup, Ben would have his hair gelled up to give him more of a super secret agent kind of look. I mean, obviously, it's an a-ha cover. The original a-ha video had this girl jumping into a comic book that she was reading in a little diner. But we wanted to upgrade that a little bit, update it. So what we did, we jumped into a computer screen by the power of these visors. All of us were running and jumping and dodging all these kind of viruses. You see Ben falling out of the sky, you see me doing this Matrix-style backflip.
The coolest bit in the video, without a doubt, has to be Paul's bike bit, though.
Yes,
definitely. Paul sits down in the air and then a bike builds itself around him. It was really cool. But if you actually watched it being filmed, it was probably the most uncool bit.
Yeah,
because he was sitting on a piece of thin wood.
On a bit of wood.
Which he enjoyed immensely.
Oh, right up my crack. I'll be coming for you anyway.
The most painful part of the job was hanging in those harnesses. And we had to hang sometimes. We had this really tight belt on. Basically, we're hanging in wires from the roof.
It was so painful that we actually, for some of the flying shots, we were actually just lying on boxes, on green boxes.
It's quite cleverly done.
And the bit with the explosion, where the thing explodes, where the virus explodes, basically we had like people hiding under little green, canvases type of thing, holding a piece of string. And when the director went, now, they'd pull the string and we'd like be yanked away. Yeah.
was very tiresome video to shoot, very, very tiresome. But anyway, it was a good fun video to shoot, and I think, I remember when we sat in the Sony offices in London and we had the premiere of this video, we all sat down with a big screen and we all watched it and we just loved it. We thought, this is unreal. And I even think now, you know, not many pop videos have come close to this one.
Welcome back to A1's videography, or is it videography?
Done is the beginning of every single week.
Okay, it's getting boring.
Okay, once again, we stayed with the director that gave his take on me, Stuart Gosling, and we have same old brain of you. You said you'd change, but I'm afraid it's something I won't live to see. This was definitely one of my favourite videos to shoot and to watch back because I think it looked very cool. I was more happy with the clothes in this video than I've ever been before, you know. No more disgusting, luminous yellow vests. I think everybody was really happy with how we looked in the video. This was a grubby looking video, and the plot, basically, we are there, pretty similar to the song really. We're there doing our work, we're working on we're like mechanics, we're fixing up cars, and there's this girl taking us all for a ride, playing us all for fools.
This girl that's basically, apparently she'd been with all of us, so we're trying to share that. And she'd messed us all around. Every single one of us, so we were all complete fools. Is this the way
it has to be? There was no off-air romantics going on or anything, no relationships. We all just got on with her, she was a nice girl. And nothing happened behind the scenes. As you can see, for the first time, there is no cheesy grins every 5 seconds.
I don't think any of us smile in the video, actually.
Not really.
Well, you can't really, because it's a really angry song.
But in the beginning of the shot, where you see me driving down the road in the truck, for a part of it, they didn't need me to drive the van. It was the owner of the van driving it. So what they had to do later on, they actually just docked one of my heads from another scene, made it smaller, and then put it on top of the guy's head. It was so clever. And if you look at it, you can just see the difference in quality of film when you see my computer doctored head on top of the guy that's actually driving the van.
It looks like it was shot in, somewhere hot in, the USA or something, but it was actually shot in a little town called Dungeness in Kent, back in the UK. So we were absolutely freezing.
So this video, I suppose we brought in one of the clichés of pop videos, rain, but it was a lot harder than we thought it would be because we were wearing a lot of clothes in this video. We had lots of layers and stuff, and that rain was cold.
The director actually complained afterwards and said that he had real trouble trying to put our dance routine together because it was so messy. And we did try to explain to him that we were soaked from top to bottom and our clothes were so heavy. Well, we had a great choreographer, a guy called Jamie King. He did Take On Me as well. He's been choreographing people like Michael Jackson, Janet Jackson, NSYNC. He's probably one of the best choreographers in the world. So we did our best to try and do his routine justice. No More, which is actually a very special video. Because we shot it actually in Asia, in Singapore, and it was really, really great fun because we got to pay a lot of people a lot of money to get beaten up by us.
One of the main reasons why we came to Singapore at first, because we wanted the amazing, city effect of the skyscrapers and downtown Singapore. Tell me walk away, then you go and
The video was directed by Stuart Gosling again. That's three videos in the truck.
We don't really know what this video is about. We don't know what the point of
it is. In fact, we didn't know when we got there to Singapore.
Yeah,
what we're shooting it the next day, and nobody, not even the director, knew what the video was about.
Nobody really knew what was going to happen. They had this idea of starting off with us abseiling down a very high wall, which was a lot of fun. I was quite scared doing the abseiling at the beginning of the video because the only thing that was keeping us up there at certain times was these guys on the other side holding onto the ropes. We were holding one side of the rope and we had to abseil ourselves down. Luckily, they were very strong, but I was still a little scared. And also we were told that we would be, once again, doing some stunts and driving some boats. I think the boat scenes worked really well. There was a couple of shots that had to be changed because Ben's trousers were so baggy that it almost looked like he was wearing these kind of, I don't know, Arabian, really baggy sultan type trousers. There was this shot where his trousers just looked about that wide, so we had that taken out.
We've been trained for years.
Many years, yeah.
In the art of martial ninja arts, black belts, we are...
Actually, I've got to be fair, it took 15 minutes for each of us to learn what we have to do. The guys that we were working with were fully trained stuntmen. They've worked on a number of movies over the world. And we had a very, very good trainer that has done a lot of the Hong Kong martial arts movies. And he was brilliant. He was very quick, very efficient, and these guys could take a pounding. You belong with me. What you gonna? I don't wanna hear no more. That was quite a fun part because me and Ben had to throw these guys off the top of the building, and the guy would be like saying,
"Merry Christmas,
Lucy." Like, happy as we threw him off, he'd go, "Happy New Year." There's another cutaway shot where you actually see the guy land on the floor, and he looks like he landed really badly. If you see it, he lands right on his wrist and it looks really painful, but because they're trained stuntmen, they know exactly what they're doing. You look back, same old, you know, be the first to believe, Summertime of Our Lives, Every Time, you know, all these videos, we've had the chance to do things that we probably never would have had the chance to do had we not been in A1. So we feel very, very privileged, and it's been worth it every second.